This is about exposing one of the worst MKUltra projects. This is the story of MKUltra victim Johnny X. This is related to the story of National Security Agency devil worshipper Helen Miller, aka the Witch. Johnny X is one of the witch's victims. This is also the story of Eugene Hasenfus, Reagan-era covert operative captured by communists in Nicaragua in 1986, suspected brainwashing victim. This is the story of a known brainwashing communist technique, and this program was also used to gather information, to gather brainwave patterns, and this is related to silent sound. This will become clear by the end of the video. His name was Johnny X. Johnny X was an A student. Johnny X was an athlete. Johnny X was a good athlete. Johnny X was a nice American kid. Johnny X was a friend of mine. And Johnny X was a friend of a lot of people. Unfortunately, there was nothing I could do about this when I found out what had happened to him. There was nothing I could do. This was a matter that was hoped could be resolved at a later date. And now it's much later than it was ever hoped to be. They found him in a field with his pants pulled down, dead of a PCP drug overdose. Case unresolved. So let me ask you this. If the secret government was capable 30 years ago of taking a straight A student, an athlete, who was always nice and polite, a very good person, they could take somebody like that 30 years ago and turn him into something dumped in a field with his pants pulled down, died during a failed brainwashing attempt. And ask yourselves, if the government could do this shit to someone like that 30 years ago, what do you think they can do to people now? Among things I discussed with my contact at the Lake County Sheriff's Department last year, I asked him to see if he could get any case file information on Johnny X. I talked to my contact at the Sheriff's Department back in October, and I happened to ask him if he'd had any luck locating anything on Johnny X and another case. And he said no. And unfortunately, the Lake County Sheriff's Department hands are still tied. And apparently, there's a problem with the Round Lake Beach Police Department, who should have had these files. If they have them, they don't want to share them with the Sheriff's Department. So it's a good question, why? And one problem the government's going to have with covering Johnny X's case up, if all the paperwork has disappeared on his case, well, you know what, there's quite a few people on Facebook that remember him from Round Lake, and shitbags aren't going to get away with it either. You see, unfortunately, for the shitbags in Washington that are supporting these takeovers, not only did Johnny X have a lot of friends in Round Lake, these friends are spread out across the United States. And it's not a matter of some vengeance for Johnny X. It's a matter of many of these people have children and grandchildren, and they're not going to stand by and let the evil do this shit. So anyway, getting to Hasenfus and the heart of the matter, I wrote an article on Eugene Hasenfus, likely mind control victim, August 4th last year. I'm going to put a link to that blog article. I'm going to sum it up. Eugene Hasenfus was an American who was working for Reagan on covert operations in Central America in the fight against communism in Central America. Hasenfus's plane was shot down while carrying guns. So the Nicaraguans had him in custody with the weapons, and they put him in jail. During his time in jail, he was without seeing anybody other than communist fuckers. At least for part of the time, he was without seeing anybody but communists. In 3 days' time, a person's personality can be permanently altered and then controlled for the rest of their life by the known communist brainwashing techniques that they had in the 80s. With what we know of communist brainwashing techniques from the 80s, it is entirely possible, in fact it is more than likely, that during Hasenfus's captivity in Nicaragua, the communists brainwashed him, and it is almost certain he would not even remember it. I believe nobody can dispute that I can speak as an expert on the matter of communist brainwashings from back in the 80s. It's my opinion, unless a person was prepared with the military techniques to resist known communist brainwashing and had an agent there to assist during the brainwashing, I do not believe anyone would be able to remember the brainwashing. Maybe with some kind of deep hypnosis, maybe it could be brought out. I don't think anybody has a chance. And that was against what they had back in 82. This image is my rendering of what the headgear equipment looked like, which I was shown by the Bulgarian. And as I noted previously, the Bulgarian pricked my ear so I would leave a little blood evidence inside the headgear that Miller had in her possession. We can thank our traitors in the government for screwing that shit up. So anyway, Eugene Hasenfus has been in the papers a few times since his days in captivity in Nicaragua. He's been in the papers for doing coke and masturbating in public. He was divorced prior to that. My theory in the blog article is that during Hasenfus's captivity in Nicaragua, communists brainwashed him. Then after he was over here, years later, the secret government, controlled by these communists, played with him and made him act that way. And were probably involved in supplying him with the drugs and everything. It's just my theory. Part of the reason I have this theory is because Hasenfus lives in Wisconsin, and that's where these things went down, and I know for a fact that Miller had a network there. I know for a fact. I know how these communists are, the druids, the devil worshippers who are controlling these takeovers. They're evil creatures, they enjoy inflicting pain and suffering, they're vengeful. Hasenfus was more than likely target communist revenge and torment because of what he did in the fight against communism by bringing guns into Nicaragua. I think that makes perfect sense. Now, I don't want to get sidetracked here, so I'm going to discuss this in a different video, but I'm just going to point out here, if you think this is bullshit, this is how friendly the United States is with the communists in Nicaragua and Sandinistas. This is from April 5th, 2009. 23-year-old Nicaraguan political refugee. She was beaten with sticks, shot at, nearly raped, and almost murdered because she fought for free elections. Well, our U.S. government is going to deny her asylum here. Tell me that this is not another communist abomination. So while the Obama administration denies political asylum to people who clearly need it, on the other hand, the Obama administration is more than happy to open up the floodgates to let all kind of former Soviet satellite country people in our country and not even check. In fact, he's probably putting them to work for Acorn or some shit. So anyway, the techniques for brainwashing have changed since the 80s. They're now able to brainwash people without even touching them. Silent sound, fry weapons. So if you're not familiar with silent sound, I'm attaching a little clip here to give you a little briefing. Now the silent sound and these fry weapons, these are used in organized stalking, which is electronic harassment and torture of citizens conducted by the secret government here in the United States. At last estimates, about 350,000 Americans are targeted individuals. After the short clip, there's an important point that follows.
In other words, by studying the subtle characteristic brainwave patterns that occur when the subject experiences a particular emotion, scientists have been able to identify the concomitant brainwave pattern and can now duplicate it. These modified emotion signature clusters can then be broadcast over UHF carrier frequencies, i.e. regular TV and radio signals, and sent directly into the brain, where they can then silently trigger the same basic emotion in another human being. In other words, if the emotional signature cluster for, say, a feeling of hopelessness and despair is being fed directly into your brain via unseen radio waves, you will feel those emotions.
So I hope that was clear. They can take the brain patterns of, say, someone that is feeling fear, store those patterns, and then transmit those patterns into someone else's brain and make them feel fear. They can do this by broadcasting these signals piggyback on TV and radio, or via HARP and a number of other technologies that they have. So that's what all this MKUltra experimentation has been about since 1947. To study our brains, to figure out how to take thoughts out of them and put them in other people's head, and then apply that on a global scale. Now my point here with Hasenfus's case, and the case of my school friend Johnny X, the communists didn't just study how to implant fear in us. The communists had developed a known technique to brainwash people to masturbate. As sick as that sounds, it's fucking true. The sick motherfuckers develop programming for that. And of course, some of that programming was used in the Franklin conspiracy, which was sex slaves for government people, so the government officials could then be blackmailed.
When I started shopping this story around, I was met with tremendous amounts of skepticism. There are some stories that are just so implausible and so exquisitely covered up that they can only be captured through a postmortem. And this is one of those stories.
Two more points I want to make here. Last year in my blog, I said that Reagan was gathering lists of traitors and cowards in our government, and that some of these lists were lists of people that were being blackmailed to go along with the long-range takeover of America. And my other point is about my good buddy, Michael Aquino, NSA devil worshiper, piece of shit. In July 1981, California police tried to bust him, and he used his military clout to get out of it, same way that he got out of everything else. He was on Reagan's list. The only reason Reagan didn't get rid of Aquino at the time, he couldn't, because national security said that Aquino was working a counterintelligence plan. Well, I think we can see by the way we got devil worshippers all over our country now, there was no counterintelligence plan there. Aquino's a fucking traitor.
Intelligence agencies have infiltrated and created some satanic groups, with the resurgence of these groups beginning in 1966. Aquino was an army specialist in intelligence and psychological warfare. In 1973, he became the executive officer of the 306th Psychological Operations Battalion, contemporary with his founding of the Church of Set. General Aquino's psychological warfare campaign has started or infiltrated cults and other closed systems as part of a concerted effort to control large numbers of people and to destabilize the centers of constitutional and legal authority, both here in the United States and in other nations. This methodology is part of a concerted plan that spans several generations. This methodology is part of a concerted plan that spans several generations. The Church of Satan and the Church of Set, as well as other cults and mainstream organizations, are closed systems with their own belief systems that are insular and separate from the reality that most people take for granted. During the 1960s, he was prominent in the Church of Satan and a close friend of Anton LaVey until he started his own Church of Set. A police intelligence report dated July 1, 1981 reads, quote, The Church of Set is a group of hundreds of members that operates on a national level. Michael Aquino is the official head and rules through a council of nine who are in fact his lieutenants, unquote. At least two members of the Council of Nine at that time were members of Army Intelligence. In the late 1980s, Aquino was accused by the San Francisco Police Department of being involved in a satanic child molestation ring centered on the daycare at the Presidio military base where Aquino was stationed at the time. Probable victims numbered at 68, many of whom had contracted venereal disease, claiming that criminal charges against Michael Aquino were dropped due to pressure from the Army. General Aquino admitted to renting the German castle where the Nazi SS were formed and reenacting the secret ceremony among fellow intelligence officers dressed in full Nazi regalia. General Aquino is now the highest-ranking officer in the National Security Agency, along with General Black and General Hayden. General Mike Aquino wrote From Psyop to Mind War with Colonel Paul E. Vallely, The Psychology of Victory. He discusses the use of psychotronic weapons or electronic weapons that influence the mind. Capitulation could be induced without firing a shot by using signals piggybacked on broadcasts of radio, TV, microwave communications to influence through subliminal suggestion, holograms, voice-to-skull and silent sound technologies to manipulate the feelings and thoughts of the target population. Behavior modification is a key component of peace enforcement, and modification will be directed at the American people. Dr. Persinger is saying is that virtually any mental state can be artificially injected into a human brain from an exterior source. The most frightening thing is that the means for doing this already exists in a fully operational form on a worldwide basis. Quote, the power levels for these amplitudes are similar to those associated with the signals generated globally by radio and communication system. Within the last two decades, a potential has emerged which was improbable, but which is now marginally feasible. This potential is the technical capability to influence directly the major portion of the approximately 6 billion brains of the human species by generating neural information within a physical medium within which all members of the species are immersed, unquote. Dr. Persinger's message, minus the jargon, is that the entire human race can be controlled through the use of electromagnetic influence piggybacked on television and radio networks or other technological means.
Effectively, all consciousness is due to electromagnetic patterns generated within the brain. What we do is imitate what the brain normally does and apply it experimentally.
Like, you know, where are these thoughts coming from?
Those thoughts came from the neuroscience laboratory at Laurentian University in Sudbury, Ontario.
A primary technique is the Department of Defense's Silent Sound Spread Spectrum, SSSS. It is also known as silent sound. In the private sector, the technology goes by the name of Silent Subliminal Presentation System, and the technology has also been released to certain corporate vendors. Planting inaudible messages directly into the subconscious human mind. The most insidious aspect of silent sound is that it is completely undetectable by those being targeted. Because it delivers its subliminal programming directly to the human brain via the auditory sense at frequencies that humans are incapable of perceiving as sound, there is no defense against it. Everyone on the planet is equally susceptible to mind control via silent sound, and there is no escape from it. UHF waves can be transmitted over very long distances from remotely located sources and will pass through walls and other objects as if they are not there. UHF is the frequency, 100 MHz, that has been used for television and radio broadcasting for as long as these media have existed. Perfected more than 20 years ago by the Department of Defense and battlefield tested upon unwitting Iraqi soldiers serving in the army of Saddam Hussein in the Gulf War during 1991, silent sound is a sinister weapon that has been developed for a specific mission, the total subjugation of the American people. Whether or not silent sound is coupled with a new all-digital TV signal as its means of delivery into the minds of an unsuspecting U.S. populace, it can be deployed by many different devices, including HARP and GWN towers, which would effectively blanket the entire nation at once. This is also related to documented mind control plans of National Security Agency devil worshipper Michael Aquino.
Broadcast by a number of high-powered radio transmitters operating deep in the Soviet Union since July 4, 1976. Though the official Defense Department explanation of the Woodpecker is that it is an over-the-horizon radar designed to track U.S. missile launches, some scientists suspect that the Woodpecker is designed to interfere with human brain function.
As far as I'm concerned, the potential that this has for producing a direct psychoactive effect upon the total American population is there, has never been disproven.
Dr. Robert Becker is a pioneer in the field of bioeffects of electromagnetism.
The signal range within which the Woodpecker operates is that which has been reported by many investigators to produce a tranquilizing effect upon animals.
We are just incredibly sensitive to these magnetic stimuli.
This is non-consensual human experimentation in the U.S. Silent sound operates at frequencies beyond the range of human hearing, and there is no defense against it. We are not just talking about thoughts and emotions. We are also talking about pain. Some of these weapons that are in use can cause pain. We are not just talking about adding thoughts and emotions. We are talking about a disruption of normal mental and physiological functioning. You cannot hear the transmission. There's no trace left by silent sound or the other DEW weapons. These are perfect crimes. The government covers up the attacks against individuals with torture tactics created to appear so unbelievable that bogus mental illness is used to discredit targets, or are so well disguised that they induce mysterious illnesses neutralize the victims.